Three.
Every time I say the word Taino, as a Haitian, there's backlash. I get comments and messages like this. Haitians don't have Taino heritage. Mind you, this was in response to a video I released yesterday about Haiti and Jamaica. I referenced Tainos because the Tainos were the first inhabitants of both of our lands. True facts. Here's the reality. Taino history is Haitian history. Some people need to stop gatekeeping. The story of the Taino people belongs to Haitians just as much as it belongs to Dominicans, Puerto Ricans, Cubans. Our deeper skin tone doesn't disqualify us from being able to claim the rich history, culture, ancestry the Tainos left behind for us. Haitians, we're predominantly, overwhelmingly of African descent, and we are proud to be a Black nation. At the same time, we also recognize and celebrate our indigenous roots. The very name of our country, Aitsi, is a Taino word meaning land of high mountains. It was the original name of our land. And so every time we're called by name, Haitian, Haitien, we are paying tribute to our indigenous roots. Our island, shared with the Dominican Republic, was the most populated with Tainos. And today, some Haitians can still trace a part of their ancestry back to Tainos. And that's because although the Tainos were declared extinct in 1565, some, very few, survived. They fled their Spanish colonizers and found refuge deep within the mountainous interior of our land. These Tainos created remote settlements. And when the French took over the West and began to import Africans, many of these Africans also ran away. We called them Maroons. Some of these Maroons found and joined the Taino settlements. Together, Africans and Tainos resisted slavery. It's no wonder Haiti's first army, the one that fought and beat the French, it was called the Indigenous Army. And when Haiti gained independence, one of our first constitution under Pétion, 1816, extended citizenship to the native people. The commenter said that when the French came, all of the Tainos went to the east with the Spanish. But do you really think that when the 1697 Treaty of Wiswick was signed, all of the Tainos who had gained their freedom, they packed up their belongings and they moved to the east with their oppressors? Of course not. These Tainos stayed and they interacted with Africans. And through that interaction, there was a cultural exchange. And we can see evidence of this in Haiti today. For example, look at some of our culinary techniques. The way we make cassave is a direct preservation of Taino techniques. Our language, Creole Haitien, borrows from Taino vocabulary. Look at how we say anana, lumbi, cassave, kalalu. Carnival is one of Haiti's biggest celebrations and it incorporates many native traditions and musical instruments, and religion is impacted too. Haitian voodoo is originally from Benin, but you can see many Taino influences, like through the symbols in the songs. They try to silence our history and strip us of a part of our heritage. Meanwhile, in Haiti, we have statues of Taino heroes that were born on our land, cities that were named after Tainos, like Leogon, schools named after Taino heroes, like Anacaona. We have museums filled with Taino artifacts. Oh, we know that this history belongs to us too, and so we'll continue to tell it. Viva Haiti!